pleads with the Romans for command in Spain. He asks to be able to avenge his father and uncle, and to bring glory to Rome. And despite his youth, the Romans elect him to go. Livy tells us, though, that it's not because they had any special confidence in this 25-year-old, or because of the honor they gave to his desire to avenge his father, but rather because everyone else considered a command in Spain suicide, and he was the only one who volunteered to take it on. But it turns out they chose the right man for the job. Without telling anyone except Gaius Laelius, his close friend and the commander of the fleet that was to accompany him, Scipio did the unthinkable, and with his inferior force, raced for the Carthaginian capital in Spain, Carthago Nova. Because the action was unthinkable and he hadn't told anyone his plan, not even the sub-commanders in his army, he was able to reach Carthago Nova completely by surprise. He rapidly began to assail the city. With his first attack, he tried to lure the defenders out of the city, and almost succeeded in forcing his way in, but was beaten back. Later that day, he attacked again, this time with a trick up his sleeve. He ordered his men to attack from all sides, including an assault from the harbor which Gaius Laelius and his marines had taken. He then ordered a contingent of 500 of his men to wait near a lagoon that abutted the wall of the city. And then a squall came in, just as Scipio expected. His men hadn't expected it, so to them it looked like magic as the winds drained the lagoon and allowed them to easily cross. They assaulted the section of the wall that no one had thought to defend because the lagoon made it unassailable. With all the defenders tied up with the other assaults, these 500 men opened the city, and the Romans made short work of the garrison, brutally slaughtering anyone they found until the commander of the garrison surrendered.